Hey everybody, this is the Mega Bloks Call of Duty Riverboat Raid set, inspired by and based on the level Victor Charlie from Call of Duty Black Ops, the original Black Ops 1. This goes really well with the Jungle Ranger set. Take a closer look at the boat first. Building this thing was a joy, uses a lot of interesting building techniques, and ends up with a nice shape. Not just the shape of it around the sides, but the shape of it as viewed from the side. So the railing kind of ducks down, has some nice different texturing on it, and it's got a couple of weapon emplacements with a machine gun back here that is able to be turned around. You can rotate that and also elevate and bring it down just a little bit so you can bring it right out to the rail. The one in the front is set up as a turret with a double barrel setup here. Figure is a little bit of a tight squeeze to get in there, but this whole thing is just able to rotate around. Not the best look, I would say, with the part that sticks out, but they needed to have that much depth in order to have that part work with other, basically other places they use that same part to be able to fit a figure inside of there. This is also a nice, clever build, just how they got the two barrels suspended there. Got a nice little stock here with some instrumentation up top, got a little bit of a light there. This is actual cloth, obviously, and you can see light actually going through it. That doesn't hang quite as nicely as I would like. It does feel, or does look a little bit worn and a little bit good in scale, but I wish that it was a little bit heavier just so that you could get it to maintain a little bit more of a realistic shape. You know, there's pros and cons either way. There's a spot where you can control the thing, so you can set up a figure down in there at the wheel, and there's actually a little console up on top. It's a little bit tough to see with everything built, but that's actually a printed piece up on the top there. I think it's a little bit of unnecessary detail to put print in there, but I very much appreciate it. Anytime you can get detail, it's better for collectors, for viewers, for even a little bit for play. You know, for the kids that want to play with these things, just to get a little bit more understanding of what's there and to make it seem a little bit more present and believable. There's plenty of space with the size of the boat. There's plenty of space in there to put at least two more figures on the inside. And I really like this little addition of the tire on the side that's just strapped up with a little rubber strap. This thing does not float, as you may imagine, looking at it from underneath. Got a little pocket under there. You know, pretty simple construction for the base, but then the sides are put together very nicely. The figures come on these nice little stands, which have just the two studs on the top to hold on to the feet at a width of three studs in total. They make for nice stands just by themselves like this, and they also integrate in pretty well because you can still attach them to things that are, you know, studded on the top, and it uses a fairly common mixture of colors, marbled colors, that Mega Bloks uses for terrain pieces. This is an official Mason figure here. They actually put his name on it, got the license and everything, and he's carrying the Grim Reaper, which is the personal handheld multiple launch rocket system. Comes with the four rockets that are, or projectiles that are inside of there. Has basically a two-part build to it, but they give you a couple of these little fire pieces just to indicate that one of these is in the process of being fired, so you can kind of pull one of these out. You can even bring it out farther than that. There we go. So you can get it to come out pretty far for a really nice action pose. I think that looks really good, especially when you had the sight lined up with his eyes there. Here's a better look at just the figures, both of them. The one on the right doesn't have an official name, but he does have a tattoo on the side, and he looks recognizable, but I don't recognize who he is. I never played Black Ops 1 myself, so if anybody recognizes what that character on the right is supposed to be or who it could be, just let me know down in the comments. I'd appreciate that very much. Other viewers would appreciate that as well. He's got the bandolier on, the guy on the right, which is a rubbery piece. It's stretchy. A little bit tough to get it posed in a way that isn't super awkward. I wish that it was just a little bit larger of a piece so that it wouldn't be attached in such a tight manner, you know, so it could actually drape just a little bit. But I got the best pose out of it that I could. It's got his assault rifle there. And, you know, pretty standard builds for these, but nice parts and a nice paint applications where they do appear. They also do include a single backpack, and that's the only additional accessory that's included in the set that's not been shown yet. I feel like this is a pretty perfect set for the target market. You know, it works really well for posing the figures. This will go great in all sorts of dioramas. I think that it looks good just by itself. You know, it's something that you can be happy just displaying. I think the figures are very good. The accessories work out nicely. And I think it would integrate well with other stuff. I think it's a very, very good set. I think it's just a perfect representation of what Mega Bloks is trying to do with their Call of Duty line in general. Let me know what you think. If you have any gripes about this set, anything that you think really should have been done better, or if there's anything in particular that is your favorite feature that you've seen here, leave a comment down below, and I will talk to you again very soon.